So, it is a very, very interesting project. It's a very challenging, and data prep is, you know, you're not a data janitor here. You are really making something good, okay? It's a lot of elbow grease, a lot of hard work, but the data is really messy, you know? And there is a value in that, because if you work more with the messy data, you will develop business knowledge, you know? And that is what people are looking for. So what happens that when you take all those databases and you have a hypothesis, you have a tendency to go and just prove the hypothesis right away. It's not going to happen that way, okay? I can tell you it's not going to happen that way, because that survey that I said, you know, only 70% of the executives, they think that may or may not happen. Why? Because its data is very incomplete. For example, in SIS database, what is happening in SIS database is that, you know, you have healthcare data and whatnot, but data is highly incomplete. If you go and look into the, what you call is quantitative variables, it's very, very incomplete actually. Yeah. And that's why executives don't have trust in the data. And that is the truth, you know. So what you have to do is to calculate the sample size, and it's gonna be usually like a million or more rows to do this thing. But be ready to scale back. That if you got 1,000 rows or 10,000 rows, you know, to do this predictive analytics, you should be able to go ahead, you know, because you can't get 1,000,000 rows in a POC. Remember, you're gonna get $50,000 at the max, okay? And you're gonna get like a 12 weeks, okay? Doesn't it make sense that you finish effort and as soon as possible, right? So data prep is very important. So we had all these things, and what we did in this case that, well, we have a hypothesis there, but we also took another hypothesis that the red car color and the certain age group combined to have a fraud. And we took that thing and just wanted to see, is that data available, okay? No, that data was not available, okay? You know, if that data was available, like 800 rows, 1,000 rows, things like that. So rather than taking a big hypothesis and going into it, take another hypothesis, more simpler, and then apply it to different databases to see if the data is available. Number one objective. Number two, how much time is gonna cost to prepare this data? How many hours is gonna take to prepare this data? So you gotta have all those estimates, because you have to give those estimates. Okay? All right. So that's what the story about the data prep. Now, data classification. So you have run probability statistics method to pre-fraud disposition scores for claims. Data and claim for the 14 variables has been into suspicious and non-suspicious. Information content is derived based upon summation of bins, and the probability is adjusted to 40%. Okay, let me explain that, okay? Let me just explain that. So what is happening, you know, when you do predictive analytics, a lot of people from banking, they come into healthcare and try to do, you know, predictive analytics, all right? Actually, predictive analytics is not something very new, started in 1958, and then came to retail and banking. Now, insurance companies have been taking it like 5-10 years ago, and when the banks come in, they want to use a method called weight of evidence, okay, WOE. In one sentence, what is WOE is frequency-based analysis, okay? Now, what's wrong with that? No, nothing wrong with that. It's just that healthcare is different. How it is different? Well, what is happening in healthcare, that the E&M code that I was talking about, they get billed 70% of the time, but they get paid 80% of the time. Whereas surgical codes, they get billed 18% of the time, but they get paid 70% of the time. So they just reverse. So if you take frequency, you will end up with all the ENM code that pays $100, $150, things like that. You know, so when the CEO says, show me the beef, where is the money, you know, where I'm losing, you're not able to show any money if you take the banking method, okay? So it's very important to understand what methods you're using and why that method is important and what it's gonna end up with. You know, I had the misfortune of working with one company where somebody had presented, you know, somebody, PhD and engineer and all that, and they presented excellent everything. Then the CEO asked, okay, so how much is the damage?